we'll discuss chord of contact, pole, polar, conjugate points, conjugate lines without any proof. Straight away, in case of ellipse, we discussed the difference between ellipse and hyperbola is only b square is replaced by minus b square. So let us observe equation of chord of contact is S1 is equal to 0. That can be written as xx1 by a square minus yy1 by b square equal to 1. Even if you want to write equation of polar of px1 y1 is S1 is equal to 0, xx1 by a square minus yy1 by b square equal to 1. Now we will see the conjugate points. We know that two points are said to be conjugate points if polar of either passes through the other. Two lines are said to be conjugate lines if pole of either lies on the other. Now let us find pole of lx plus my plus n is equal to 0 with respect to x square by a square minus y square by b square equal to 1. Now when you say that pole of some line means basically that line is a polar. So for every polar there exists a pole, for every pole there corresponds one polar. So let px1 y1 be the pole of lx plus my plus n is equal to 0. So this is equation 1, this is equation 2. Now polar of px1 y1, just now we have written that is s1 is equal to 0, xx1 by a square minus yy1 by b square minus 1 equal to 0. Now equation 2 and 3 represent the same polar. So comparing 2 and 3, so what do you get now? X1 by a square divided by L is equal to y1 by b square, of course with minus, divided by m is equal to minus 1 by n. So x1 by a square L is equal to y1 by minus b square m is equal to minus 1 by n. Therefore x1 comma y1 is given by, it is minus a square L by n comma b square m by n. So these are the pole coordinates. Now we'll derive the condition for lines to be conjugate. So consider L1x plus M1y plus N1 equal to 0, and we are having one more line L2x plus M2y plus N2 is equal to 0, standard hyperbola x square by a square minus y square by b square equal to 1. Now if you claim that these two are conjugate lines, no doubt pole of this line lies on this line. So let us write pole of L1x plus M1y plus N1 equal to 0 with respect to hyperbola is, now already we derived with Lx plus My plus N. So the difference between this line, which line, L, this line and this one is only suffixes. So it will become minus a square L1 by N1 comma b square M1 by N1. This lies on our second line L2x plus M2y plus N2 is equal to 0. Now substitute L2 into minus a square L1 by N1 plus M2 into b square M1 by N1 plus N2 is equal to 0. Now you can see minus a square L1 L2 plus b square M1 M2 plus N1 N2 is equal to 0. Send these two terms to the right hand side. A square L1 L2 minus b square M1 M2 is equal to N1 N2. Now this is the ideal condition for the lines to be conjugate. If you want, you can derive condition for conjugate points also. So x1 comma y1, x2 comma y2 are conjugate points, means polar of px1 y1 passes through qx2 y2, right? Now let us write polar of px1 y1 is s1 is equal to 0, xx1 by a square minus yy1 by b square equal to 1. It passes through x2 y2 means x1 x2 by a square minus y1 y2 by b square minus 1 equal to 0. This is the condition s12 equal to 0. So s12 equal to 0 is the condition for two points to be conjugate points, and a square n1 n2 minus b square m1 m2 equal to n1 n2 condition for the lines to be conjugate.